I didn't realize bumblebees were that important. I always looked for honeybees, but now I see bumblebees out there, so now I've kind of watched for that. We have our own hives, and my neighbor has a few hives, so it's just kind of a, you know, I don't hire any bees, anybody with bees, it's just our own, so we really keep an eye on them. So, and I've learned a lot, you know, I know a lot about the bees that through our hives, so we really watch them to make sure there's no problems with them.
We use primarily honeybees and bumblebees on our farm to pollinate. The honeybees right now come from Florida. As time went on, we felt like maybe we needed more pollination than just what the honeybee was doing, because it has times where it won't fly if it's cloudy and windy and hot, or rainy and cloudy. So, you know, there's times that they won't work, so we thought we would add to it by using some bumblebees. Bumblebees are supposed to fly pretty well in all weather, even sometimes at night. And plus, a bumblebee, it's my understanding, will successfully pollinate a watermelon in one visit, the bloom in one visit, where a honeybee takes multiple visits, I think 8 or 9 visits by a honeybee. So we felt like maybe we would get a little bit better pollination by using a combination of both, honeybees and bumblebees.
We also had a Indiana beekeeper, and we still have that same beekeeper, but he has expanded and taken on a partner. And so now our bees do come from Florida because they've got enough bees that they're doing that. I've always been like a half a hive to the acre, but I'm trying to increase that as I can if I can afford it. And we also use bumblebees, but I use bumblebees more on the early cantaloupe only, instead of keeping them in the watermelons long season, because I feel like that the bumblebees get out there in the field earlier when the weather's not as good for the honeybees. Colder weather and cloudier weather, and when you're shooting for an early market, early pollination is important. I'm not sure there's enough wild bees out there, so I would be really scared to try none managed hives.
And then we've had issues getting what we considered good honeybee hives. We changed suppliers in Florida because of that reason, and we felt like we weren't getting full hives. So we want to get a active hive that we feel like's full. So my daughter and I decided that we'd start growing some of our own. So this year we bought some nukes and some beehives and started raising our own honeybees. And it's a learning process for sure. It's something that hopefully won't kill them all the first year. We'll have some there to start with next year.
I always ask my beekeeper every year, even when he comes, if he's around in the summer, and I ask him how they're doing. I want to know. I want an update in case something's not looking right, and I want to know if it's my fault.
Well, I know there's not, there's certain times of the year there's nothing for the bees to pollinate, so we do raise certain, like asters for the fall, and now we're into milkweed. We're putting out a lot of milkweed now for butterflies, and the bees use them too. So yeah, we're trying to make sure they got something, and on winter time you can't, but as much as the growing season we can, we try to keep something for them. So we just got into milkweed, so we're really gonna put a lot of it out next year. So we are looking for other plants other than just produce. So yeah, that's something we're into now. So
we've researched that some, trying to find out what might be best to have a habitat for bees to use during when cantaloupes or watermelons aren't blooming, hopefully to keep them close to home and in a safe area where they're not getting insecticides sprayed on them in a cornfield or a bean field.